Good afternoon, I'm meteorologist Matt Surwey. The latest on our approaching winter storm in just about 30 seconds. Got to get through this afternoon first, and it's pretty nice out there. Take a look at temperatures already in the mid to upper 30s across parts of the metro, low 40s off to our south. And that warm air to the south is going to be a recurring theme as we go forward through this forecast. Temperatures should reach the low 40s in Omaha this afternoon, and that's good because that means the rain-snow mix would not be an issue. You can see it showing up on radar. A lot of this is not reaching the ground as you get toward Hebron, Beatrice, York, Grand Island, maybe a few light snow showers as you get to the western parts of the Tri-Cities. But a lot of this is evaporating before it reaches the ground. It's just pushing in a lot of clouds in our direction. If we do see any precipitation this afternoon, most likely it would be a light rain snow mix, especially west of Omaha, but we could see a few light rain or snow showers in during the evening drive. Plenty of moisture back off to our west. It has been snowing pretty well across southwestern Nebraska so far today. Now, as far as the advisories, the winter weather advisory off to our south in the purple counties from Beatrice through Shenandoah, and then the winter storm warning, Lincoln, the Omaha Metro, the I-80 corridor in western Iowa, the blizzard warning, blizzard conditions, so 35-mile-an-hour winds for 3 hours or greater, that is off to our north and west. So even though we had the blizzard watch yesterday for most of the area, and now we have a winter storm warning, don't let that make you feel any better, because it's still going to be a really rough storm as we go into tonight and tomorrow morning. Here's Storm Predictor at 4 o'clock. Again, you see the better chance for precipitation off to our west. Can't rule out that stray rain or snow shower in the metro. As we go toward midnight, precipitation gets a little bit closer. It might start off as a little bit of light rain in Lincoln and in Omaha, but quickly overnight, the cold air is going to wrap in pretty quickly. And look at this. Heavy snow continuing as we go through Tuesday morning, and we could actually hear a few cracks of thunder as well. Thunder snow is possible with this system, especially from Omaha off to the north and west. We're stopped here at 11 o'clock on Tuesday. Remember I mentioned the warm air to the south. Look at the rain snow line. It could be as close as Plattsmouth, Bellevue, maybe even the south side of Council Bluffs to the Omaha Metro. This is something we're going to be watching very closely as we go through the afternoon. That's the leading edge of the dry slot, some slightly warmer air working in. Meanwhile, back off to the northwest, if you're in Fremont, Columbus, York, Ottawa, Norfolk, you guys are all going to be dealing with snow. So it's still going to be coming down pretty good going through noon, tapering off to a little bit of light snow through the afternoon, and then the back edge of this system works through here by midnight. All the while, very windy conditions too. I don't think blowing and drifting snow is going to be an issue going into Tuesday night and Wednesday morning, because it will be a wet, heavy snow. Here's the latest snow forecast. The only thing that has changed, that 3 to 6 inch line, but a little bit closer toward Bellevue. If you live in Bellevue, you could be around 5 to 7 inches. If you live in downtown, midtown Omaha, 6 to 8 inches. You get farther to the west, you could see some 10-inch totals popping in there. So it looks like the most populated areas are going to see the biggest change in snowfall over a very small distance. To the west, that's where we have the thundersnow potential. That's where we have the potential of seeing over a foot of snow. York, Columbus, Fremont, Takema, Ottawa, even toward Denison. Meanwhile, off to the south, well, sorry, Nebraska City, sorry, Falls City, if you wanted snow, doesn't look like you're going to get too much out of this. Again, only about 1 to 3 inches in that direction. Still, a lot can change with this forecast, especially with that dry slot coming in, especially where we see any types of thunder snow. Those are the two wild cards as we go forward through this next forecast. So Chief Meteorologist Bill Ramby will be in later today to update you on the latest at 5, 6, 9, and 10. And can keep checking here on KETV.com for all of our latest video forecast updates. I will see you guys tomorrow morning on First News. Please don't go outside. Just sit inside and stay warm.